Hello, everyone. Good afternoon. I hope everyone's doing well. Hello to my new subscribers. Hello to my old subscribers. And hello to my faithful supporters. How is everyone? I hope everyone is doing well. Welcome back to my channel. I've done several wig reviews lately, and this is one of the units. She's by Bobby Boss, and her name is Otto. And I trimmed some bangs for her, and she looks really cute with those pulled down too, when I've got them all pulled down. I'll show you some other time, but just wanted to pop in, see how everyone was doing, let you know how my doctor visit went today. I went back to the doctor to get the results of my test. When I had surgery and had some skin removed, they sent it off to the pathologist. And everything came back good. Everything was precancerous. Nothing was cancerous. So that's great. That's always a good thing. And as for my smoking, I'm still doing well. I average about, well, I just did a video yesterday, so that's how I'm doing on my smoking. If you watched that video, you know, and if you didn't watch that video, then go and check it out. But in the video, I say that I'm scared to add up how much I would spend a year on cigarettes, that it had to be, you know, about $1,000. No, it is not. I have been spending over $4,000 per year to smoke 2.5 to 3 packs of cigarettes a day. Yes, I did not stutter. Over $4,000. You talk about incentive to stop smoking. Honey, hush. That's incentive. That right there is, I could buy a car. I could buy a boat. I could pay lots of bills. I could buy my husband nice things. $4,000 worth of nice things, and I do believe it added up to be $4,700 and something dollars. So, yeah. Soon it will be zero money spent on cigarettes. So far, you know, it's just been in the last week, $4 and some odd cents. I'm not sure. But it's soon going to be zero. I just did not have what it takes to stop cold turkey, to put on the brakes and just stop. But anyway, so that's how the smoking is going. That's how the doctor visit was, which I was just so ecstatic to get the results back from the doctor. So let me tell you about my kitty cat, Sebastian. So yesterday, I am on the back porch having those 3 or 4 puffs off a cigarette that I have on the back porch because I no longer smoke in the house. And my husband was back there with us. And there is a robin's nest on top of one of our ladders in the garage. She's used it twice to raise a brood. This is her second brood. They have feathers all over them. You know, I know they're about ready to fly. I get to noticing there's not 3, there's only 2. Well, I thought, I looked all over for it in case it fell out of the nest, couldn't find it. So we're sitting out there, and all of a sudden, Gary says, "Get your blankety blank blank blank." So I turn my head and look. Sebastian has climbed the rungs of that ladder that's closed up. Now, it's not open. It's closed up. He has climbed the rungs on that ladder, and he's almost up to that nest. So I jump up and I go get him. I put him in the house, tell him he's grounded till the babies fly away. I look all over for that third one again. Then I start looking for the corpse, you know, because I figure Sebastian's got it. Has gotten it during the day before we were out there. I look all under the porch, beside the porch, out there under the nest, in the garage, in the yard. I never did find it. The cat knows how to climb a ladder. I still can't get over that. But anyway, I come home today from the doctor and all three of the birds are gone. So the other two have flown off too. And the other one that was missing most likely flew off. And I grounded the cats for nothing. But they've been in the house all day because the mama and the daddy are now out there teaching those little'uns how to fly. They're making all kind of ruckus and noise out in the yard doing their tweet tweets, and the babies will tweet tweet back, and the mamas and the daddies will tweet tweet. And I have such a respect for nature that I did keep my cats in today. They've not been out all day and they're not going out until tomorrow. So I walk out there to destroy the robin's nest off of the ladder, and there is an egg in it already. Another egg. So I've got to decide whether to destroy the egg and the nest, or put the nest and the egg in a birdhouse and nail it to the garage wall right there where she's been making her nest and hope she goes in there. I think I'm just going to destroy the one egg and the nest, and then she'll just have to lay somewhere else. But will she have time to build another nest before she gets ready to lay that second egg, or is it already on the way here? I have such a respect for nature that I honestly think about these things. My husband thinks I'm insane. I don't think I'm insane. I honestly think about these things. You know, what does a bird do if it's ready to lay an egg and there's nowhere to lay it? Do they hold it? Can they suck it up like we do when we need to go and just hold it? I don't know. So I haven't decided yet what I'm going to do about the bird's nest, but I'm going to do something this evening. Either fix it up with a house and put it in there and hope they get in there, or just destroy that one egg and the bird's nest. But something's got to be done, because my cat will eat every single one of babies, every single baby that bird and the daddy bird makes. My Sebastian will kill every one of them. He killed all of Monk's family. He's a killer. He's a young, rambunctious kitty cat. He's doing only what is in his nature, but I'm only doing what's in my nature. And we're having battle, Sebastian and I are. Let's see what else. While I'm at the doctor today, the doctor is not focused on what's going on with me. Obviously, my husband was dipping at the hospital, because my doctor is telling me that my husband needs to see a dentist regularly and to stop dipping. And to stop smoking. Now, I don't know so much about my doctor focusing in on my husband. I'm the patient, and I still don't know how I feel about that. That's just weird. Anyway, I didn't tell him that Gary dips. I rarely tell anybody. It's not a subject that comes up very often. So he must have seen Gary dipping or saw it in Gary's mouth when he was talking to him after they brought me to recovery after my surgery. So anyway, I had to listen to that today. You know, then I had to listen to get down to 3 cigarettes and pick a stop date. Stop on that date, don't smoke anymore, which that was my plan anyway, but I've got to do this at my own pace or I'm not going to be successful. I do want to be a non-smoker and I want to save all of that money. So I will get where I need to be eventually. But anyway, so that's about it, people. I've covered my day, my opinions, my thoughts, and I hope every one of you have a good afternoon. And as I said when I began, thank you so much to my loyal supporters, the people that constantly comment and watch my videos. I thank you so very much from the bottom of my heart. And I thank my new subscribers, and I thank my old subscribers. I now have 128 subscribers. I had 130 2 or 3, 4 days ago, but I think they unsubscribed because I've not been able to watch any videos lately. I've been very busy, and it's not been with YouTube. So I lost a couple of subscribers somewhere or another. But I know people that are YouTubers that swear that they go up and down, you know, that people aren't subscribing and then not subscribing, that it goes up and down, you know, on its own for no reason. I don't know so much about that, but, anyway, I have 128 and I am very flattered. I'm very flattered that there are 128 people in the world that want to watch my boring videos. But anyway, everybody be safe, be kind to one another, and I will see you again soon in my next video. Bye-bye, everybody.